Good morning, students. Today we start with unit 4, that is management principle. Now, what are principles? Like we in science we have principles, in management also we have principles. Now, principle management are based and general guidelines for manager decision making and behavior. So they are general guidelines who guide manager how to take decision in particular situation. They can be used for conduct in workplaces under certain situations. They help managers to take and implement decisions. The principles of management act as a guide for practice of management. So they are just guidelines. They help in predicting what would happen if the principles were applied. Now, principles of management are not as rigid as principles of pure science. Like, take an example. According to Newton's law, there is a gravitational pull. The apple will fall down also, only. But in case of management, this does not happen. The way of applying principle in India is different. The way of applying principle in America is different. In Japan is different. So, it's a humanly behavior. Principle of management deal with human behavior and cannot be tested in laboratories like the principle of pure science. Now, techniques are procedures or methods which involves a series of steps to be taken to accomplish desired goals. Principles are guidelines to take decision or action while practicing techniques. Now, management principles are derived, formulated on the basis of observation and analysis of events which managers have to face in actual practice. Another method of deriving management principle is conducting experimental studies. Now, nature of principle management, they are general guidelines formulated by practice experiments. They are contingent, they are flexible, they are universally applicable, that is pervasive. Established cause and effect relationship is there and they are behavior. Now, general guidelines, the principles of management are general guidelines to managerial function. But they do not provide ready-made solution to all major problems. This is so because real business situations are very complex and dynamic and are a result of many factors. But now, they are only general guidelines. They will only guide. They are not fixed. So it varies from person to person. It varies from place to place. They are formed by practice and experiment. Management principles are not developed overnight. They are derived on the basis of observation and analysis of events which managers face in actual practice. Secondly, they are derived after conducting experimental studies. So studies were there, then they were derived. Now, contingent. Management principles are not static or absolute in nature. Their application is contingent or depend upon the prevailing situation at a particular point of time. Now, today, in COVID, it's different. 1 year back, it was different. Now, this depends upon the time. There is a, for example, there is a principle of fair remuneration. This means remuneration should be based on paying capacity of the organization and the contribution made by an employee in the organization. Now, they are flexible. Flexible, they are not rigid. They change from people to person to person from time to time. Many principles are not set of rigid description on how to manage. They can be modified by manager to meet the needs of the situation. For example, the principle division of work may not be applicable in small firm to the same extent as in the last one. So a person who is selling food or burgers in a chain, he can't apply. But a person who is selling burger, owner of McD or any food chain, they can apply the principle, this principle. Now, universal applicable, whether it's in America, whether it's India, whether it's Japan, they are universally applicable. Universal now means that the principle of management are applicable all types of organization, whether they are small or big, at all levels, at all times. For example, the principle of delegation of authority is considered as a key to success of an organization irrespective of nature of business because it empowers people to take decisions on the spot. Now, establish the effect and effect relationship, cause and effect. The principle of management establishes a relationship between cause and effect. So they tell the manager if a particular principle applied in a particular situation, what may be likely effect. For example, according to principle division of work. Now in division of work, you have to divide the work in small parts. If work is divided between people based on their knowledge and experience, it will lead to efficiency. In this case, the division of work is the cause and the increase in efficiency is the effect. However, the principle of management are less than perfect because they mainly apply on human behavior. Real-time situations are not identical, so accurate cause and effect relationship may be difficult to establish. Now, behavior. Management principles are mainly behavior in nature because they aim at influencing behavior of human beings. Moreover, principles of management enable a better understanding to the relationship between human and material resources in accomplishing organization goals. For example, while planning the layout of a factory, the principle of order means placing a right person at a right place and placing the right material at the right place, requires that work flows are matched by flow of material and movement of men. Thank you.